day at Valley Field, followed by an after-school swim at the town pool, an extended stay at Canopy Lake Park, and an evening history Super Bowl competition. I would like to thank my classmates whose cooperation has made this possible, and the teachers who supported our officers and representatives' ideas. Oh, one additional announcement. After the ceremony, you are all invited to attend the reception in the cafeteria. Once again, welcome, and I hope you enjoy this evening's activities.
Tonight, this is just one milestone that we are passing, and we are glad that you are sharing this. Thank you. It is my privilege and my pleasure on behalf of the school board and the staff to extend a sincere congratulations to the class of 1994. I want to take just a few minutes to...
You've always struggled, man. We've all tried out for the sports team you've always wanted to be part of. I think we all agree we've always gotten by with a little help from our friends. We will always be able to get by with a little help from the friends we've all cherished during our 8 years experience together. Now a song written by Paul McCartney and John Lennon. I get by with a little help from my friends.
Eric Andrew Roberts.
Ross Kenneth Friedler. The experience I've had at Kelly has been most fruitful. In these 4 years, I've grown both mentally and physically, more considerably on the mental side, as you can see. I've made many acquaintances with very modern people. Today, I'd like to look back upon these 4 years and highlight those memories which stand out most in my mind. Let's begin where it all started, fifth grade. We were eager to begin our career at this new site. Upon arrival, the building was rather large and complex, with a big knot in my shoe. Life was simple. My biggest problems were finding the bathroom and carrying my backpack. Yes, it was the MC Hammer Vanilla Ice era. Yes, fifth grade was undoubtedly a strange time period. I had a scuzz haircut. Some of the things you might have overheard that year. All right, indoor recess, Chinese football. Hey, Atef, do you like wearing baggy fluorescent pants? How about some of that happy feeling vanilla? As you can see, the fifth grade year was peculiar. Fifth grade was the foundation on which I grew up and to school. After fifth grade, we moved up to sixth grade. Sixth grade was the year I found it hardest to remember. It was sort of lost in the middle of all the other grades, but no particular significance. We dominated the fifth grade, but we were no match for the seventh grade. I remember that most of the sixth grade year was spent anxiously talking about the sex education unit in the seventh grade. I recall watching out the window as the other five built upon small rockets. It wasn't until the seventh grade that things began to change. There are two extremes here, Miss Kent and Mr. Perot. One was liberal and one was conservative. One was science and one was social studies. One was a woman, one was a man. One was hands-on and one was textbook. I was often confused making adjustments before the two. I recall once leaving this answer in the mud clutching. My shoes were covered in mud. The second I stepped into Mr. Burroughs' classroom, he was quick to say, "Were your shoes off? I don't want you tracking on my all of my class." Seventh grade was a year that math became more difficult for some of us in pre-elementary. No longer was it a heavy burden for hanging my book bag at the stairs. Not for me. I was on a flat plane. In fact, never again would I ever have to hang my bag at the stairs in the elementary. One of the major factors in my seventh grade daily routine was lunch. 30 minutes of uninterrupted eating. Often for me, it was only 5 minutes. The first 25 minutes, I would often spend discussing social issues with my peers. Also, the seventh grade was a time of expansion for my life. As other people were involved, so did my lunch bag. It expanded from the size of a small brown bag to the size of a full-grown grocery bag. Certainly, my lunch symbolized the changing nature of us all during this time period. Seventh grade was a year of lunch topping in hall. I recall hearing a number of men said, "Hey, I had the coolest dream of Mr. Rose Bunch today." "Hey, we've got problems. Let's go to guidance." "Swim." "Sex head test, yeah, no problem. UVA." In conclusion, seventh grade was a year of many changes. Most of them feel better. Soon enough, the 8th grade year is upon, and it will be my favorite year yet. Yes,